Arriving at the Capitol with his party, President Truman is welcomed by a joint session of Congress. In addition to asking immediate passage of the first step of the Marshall Plan for European aid, the president offers his own program for fighting inflation and reducing taxes.
High prices must not be our means of rationing. We must deal effectively and at once with the high cost of living. We must stop the spiral of inflation. Many of our families today are suffering hardship because of the high cost of living. At the same time, profits of corporations have reached an all-time record in 1947. Corporate profits totaled $17 billion after taxes. This compared with $12.5 billion in 1946, the previous high year. Because of this extraordinarily high level of profits, corporations can well afford to carry a larger share of the tax load at this time. I recommend, therefore, that effective January 1st, 1948, a cost of living tax credit be extended to our people, consisting of a credit of $40 to each individual taxpayer and an additional credit of $40 for each dependent. Thus, the income tax of a man with a wife and two children would be reduced to $160. The credit would be extended to all taxpayers, but it would be particularly helpful to those in the low-income group. When we have conquered inflation, we shall be in a position to move forward toward our chosen goals. As we do so, let us keep ever before us our high purposes.
East meets West in the annual Shrine Charity Classic in San Francisco. The West's Herman Wiedemeyer of St. Mary's thrills the crowd of 60,000 with this run back early in the game. The Western All-Stars then call on Ed Smith of Texas Mines. Smith gets airborne for a nice chunk of yardage, which sets up a Wiedemeyer pass to Bruce of Washington for a touchdown. The game's first. But that's all for the West. Johnny Lujack of Notre Dame, All-American, connects with Mihailovich of Indiana. And from here out, it's all East. Lujack lives up to his reputation with four touchdown passes, this one to Columbia's Bill Swiaki, and scoring one touchdown himself. And he causes the West more trouble besides. Wiedemeyer's pass in the second quarter is intercepted by none other, Lujack. It's more than just the luck of the Fighting Irish. Notre Dame's Johnny went west, and the West is dizzy. Swiaki snares another Lujack aerial as the Easterners roll relentlessly. When Lujack and company are done passing and catching and running, it's East 40, West 9.